people, my name's Nicole, and today I have my March, yes, it's March, book haul. I'm so proud of myself this month. Not only did I get a slightly more reasonable number of books, but I've already read almost every single book I got this month. So for once, I'm not like drowning in books. I'm so proud of myself. I mean, don't get me wrong, I still have like an absurd number of books on my TBR, but at least I'm like getting to the point where I'm kind of balancing out number of books I've gotten with the number of books that I'm reading. Thank God for readathons, am I right? Alright, so let's just jump right into the books. And I will say that there are a few books that I'm not including in these. I already hauled them in my Emerald City Comic Con haul. They're mostly just comics and miscellaneous things that I sort of like picked up for free. So I'll link that in the doobly-doo. So the first book I bought was Stranger Than Fanfiction by Chris Colfer. And this is one I was so excited for. I love Chris Colfer's writing, and this is about a celebrity who's on a very popular show, and he is a bit of a partier. He's gotten himself a bit of a reputation as a bad boy, and his publicist is saying, and like the studio is saying, that he needs to fix his image. And one day some of his fans send a letter to him, basically just kind of jokingly being like, hey, we're going on this road trip together, wanna come? And he responds and says, yeah, yes, I would love to come. Thank you for inviting me. And so he goes on this road trip with his fans. I started to read this, I ended up DNFing it, so I'll talk about why that is in my wrap up, but I was really looking forward to it. Then I got The Inexplicable Logic of My Life by Benjamin O'Leary Sames. I loved his previous book, Arian Dante, of course. Everyone loves Arian Dante, pretty much. And it's about a teenage boy who was adopted when he was very, very young by his dad, who is a Mexican gay man. He raised him all his life. He doesn't really particularly have much of an interest in his biological parents. His grandmother starts dying. There's a lot going on with his friends and with his school that he's dealing with. And so it's very much just sort of a slice of life look at his world, being the adopted white son of a gay Latino man in this Latino neighborhood. And I've already read this one, and I'll talk about it in my wrap up. Then I got some comics, and the first two I got were the first two volumes of Spider-Gwen. This one's actually volume zero. I don't know a ton about Spider-Gwen. I do know that it's Gwen Stacy in sort of an alternate universe as their version of like Spider-Man, but like Spider-Woman, Spider-Girl, whatever, I don't know what she goes by, but I've heard really, really good things about it, and a friend of mine cosplayed Spider-Gwen at Comic-Con, and so I thought I should probably read up on what's all the hype been about. Then I got volume two of DC Bombshells, and I read the first volume last year, I think, and I really enjoyed it, so I thought I should probably get around at some point to reading the second volume. This is pretty much just badass DC women in like the 40s, and it's super diverse, really queer. I really, really enjoyed the first volume, so I can't wait to see what kind of mischief they get up to in the second volume. Then I got The Careful Undressing of Love by Corianne Haidu, and this is maybe magical realism, maybe just contemporary, I'm not quite sure. I did read it, and I came out of it with that sort of doubt as to whether or not it was magical realism or not. I'm not quite sure, but anyway, this is about a girl who lives on the street in New York, and this street has a bit of a reputation for being curse. Any man who the girls on the street fall in love with dies. And this is about her dealing with, you know, she grew up with her mom always being like, oh, this, you know, it's just a rumor, it's just sort of hype, and it doesn't really mean anything. And then one of her best friend's boyfriend dies, and all of a sudden this curse that has always been just sort of a laugh is suddenly very real. Like I said, I have read this, I'll talk about it in my wrap up. Then I picked up City of Saints and Thieves by Natalie C. Anderson, and this I actually already have a review of up because I got an ARC a while ago. I'll link my review in the doobly-doo. But this is about a girl who, she and her mother are refugees from the Congo, and they're currently living in a big city in Kenya. And 4 years ago, her mother was murdered while working as a maid in a very wealthy household. And she spent the past 4 years living on the streets, learning sort of the tricks of the trade and trying to get her revenge. And now she is finally at the point where she is ready to get that revenge. Then I got Daughter of the Pirate King by Trisha Levenseller. And this is about a pirate princess, as the title would suggest, she is the daughter of the Pirate King, and she is on a mission with her crew, and she gets captured by an enemy pirate ship. But it's okay, because this was her plan all along. There is something on that ship that she has been tasked to find, and she has to find it while also potentially falling for one of her captors. Again, I already read this. I read it for the Femme Power Blog along with a few of the other books in this haul. So I talked about those in my Femme Powerthon wrap-up, and then I'll also briefly talk about them in my wrap-up for the entire month. And then the final books I got this month are the physical copies of Check Please. This is one of my favorite webcomics. And the other had a Kickstarter back in, I think, November for publishing the volume, the physical volume 2. I donated, so I got these beautiful, beautiful physical copies in the mail this month, and they just make me so happy because they're great and like super high quality, and it just makes me so happy. If you don't know what the web series is about, obviously I will link it in the doobly-doo, but this is about Eric Biddle, who is this super, super sweet, just full of southern charm boy who is in his first year of college. He's going into college. He grew up as a figure skater. He is the best baker you have ever heard of. Seriously, he's amazing. And for various reasons, he can't figure skate in college, so he goes on to the hockey team. And it's just about him and interacting with these hockey bros, and he's this tiny, adorable southern gay boy interacting with these amazing, hilarious, just so impossible not to love bros. And it's just so good, and like, I highly, highly recommend it.
Oh, hey guys, welcome to my floor, super quick. You know how I said that like, this was my first book haul in a while that wasn't ridiculous? Yeah, never mind. I got that package of books that I'd been expecting from my lovely friend Allison, who has access to ARCs and gives me lots of fun toys. So I have more books to haul. So the first book I got was Margaret Stoll's Royce Rolls, and this is about a teenage girl who is on her family's reality show. I think it's going into season 6. And her family is very sort of Kardashian, but she is kind of done with it. She wants out. Luckily, it seems like the next season is going to be canceled, but unfortunately, just as soon as things seem like they're going to sort of go to normal, shit goes down, and suddenly her life is even crazier than ever. Then I got Your Welcome Universe by Whitney Gardner, and this is already out. It came out on March 7th, and this is about a girl who goes to a school for the deaf. And at one point she finds graffiti with a slur about her best friend, and so she covers it up, but then her best friend rats her out and she's sent to just a regular public school where she continues her graffiti art and ends up getting into a bit of a graffiti war. Then I have Saints and Misfits by S.K. Ali, and this, I'm not quite sure what it's about. The back cover says, "There are three kinds of people in my life. Saints, those special people moving the world forward. Sometimes you gaze right through them, or at least I do. They're in your face so much you can't see them, like how you can't see your nose. Two, misfits, people who don't belong, like me, the way I don't fit into dad's brand new family, or into the leftover one composed of mom and my older brother, mama's boy, Muhammad. Also, there's Jeremy and me, misfits, because although alliteratively speaking, Jana and Jeremy sound good together, we don't go together. Same planet, different worlds. But sometimes worlds collide and beautiful things happen, right? Three, monsters. Well, monsters wearing Saint masks, like in Flannery O'Connor stories, like the monster at my mosque. People think he's holy, untouchable, but no one has seen under the mask but me." So I believe this is a book about a Muslim girl who something happens at her mosque with someone who I would guess is in a position of power. I'm not quite sure exactly what the specific goings on are, but we shall see. And this comes out in June. And then I have Little Rex by Meredith Miller. And this is about three teenage girls who are kind of just sick of their hometown. They're sick of everybody in it. And it seems like they might be kind of a little bit pyromaniac-ish. So it seems like it's going to be kind of a coming of age, maybe a little dark contemporary. I don't know. This comes out in June. Then I have The Heartbeat of Wing Jones by Catherine Weber. And this is already out. I actually really want to pick up the British edition at some point because it has this gorgeous ombre on the pages. But this is about a girl who's sort of perfect golden boy older brother who she totally worshipped, died in, I believe, a drunk driving accident. And afterwards, she is just feeling kind of lost, and she doesn't really know what to do. But she finds herself sneaking out every night to go run on the track just to make herself feel better. And one day, her brother's best friend sees her, and they start to become friends and start to train together. Then I got Alex Approximately by Jen Bennett, and this comes out on April 4th. And this is about a girl who is a total classic movie buff, and she strikes up this friendship that eventually develops into something maybe a little bit more with this guy named Alex. And at one point, she ends up moving to his hometown and getting a job at the local museum, where she has to deal with this really annoying guy who is one of her coworkers and may kind of turn out to be Alex. It says he is Alex Approximately. Not quite sure what that means, but it sounds like it's gonna be a cheesy, fluffy romance, and I'm so here for it. Then I have Echoes of Memory, which is the second book in the Ravenborn series, and this is already out. And this, the first book in the series is about this girl who goes to this art school, and there is some kind of weird magical thing going on with her. I read it, I don't really remember very much about it, but I figured I liked it enough that I'm willing to read the second book. All right, so the next book I got is A Flame in the Mist by Renee Adier. And this is the same woman who wrote Wrath in the Dawn, which I really enjoyed. And this is about a girl who, she is the daughter of a samurai in feudal Japan. And her brother was trained to be a badass warrior, but she was sort of always just expected that she would get married. But one day when she was sort of on her way to meet her betrothed, she was attacked and everyone other than her was killed, and she is now trying to figure out who attacked her. She finds the general like organization that ordered the hit, and she infiltrates them, which sounds like it's gonna be really cool and pretty badass. And then I got The Gentleman's Guide to Vice and Virtue by Mackenzie Lee, and this comes out June 20th, and I am so excited to read this. From what I understand, this is a book about a teenager, young adult in like the 18th century Europe who is kind of just like gallivanting around Europe being rambunctious and gay, which sounds amazing, and I am so excited to read it. I've heard absolutely amazing things about it. Then I have It's Not Like It's a Secret by Misa Sugira. I'm sorry if I pronounced that wrong. This comes out May 9th. And this is, from what I understand, a book about a relationship between an Asian girl and a Latina girl, and them sort of dealing with coming out and some like race relations stuff. I am a little apprehensive on this because I've heard some people talking about some things that the sensitivity reader for this said about some issues with the racial discussions. On one hand, I am very aware that like I am not in a position to sort of say whether or not the things that this says are definitively like okay or not because I'm white, but I also think it's important to acknowledge that it was a sensitivity reader who said that, so she got a very, very early copy and her job was to, you know, tell them what had issues, and I don't know how many of those or if any of them have been fixed. And I think it's really important to, you know, see if the author took their feedback or not. So I don't know. We'll see. I'm curious as to what people, other people who are people of color and have a little bit more of that perspective, are going to say about sort of the finished product. The last book I have is Dress Codes for Small Towns by Courtney Stevens, and this one doesn't come out until I think August 29th. And this is about a girl who lives in a small town with sort of her little group of best friends, and things get a little more complicated when they start falling for each other. Problem is, she started falling for her best guy friend and her best girlfriend at the same time. And then those two start falling for each other. So like, it's a love triangle and it's like actually a triangle. I haven't seen a love triangle like this since Infernal Devices. So I am very excited to read this. I hope it'll be a really, really good discussion of queerness. Fingers crossed for some polyamory TBH. We'll find out. Anyway, this sounds really, really good. So those are all the books I got this month. Let me know if you guys have read any of these books in the comments. I love you guys and I will see you later.